Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today in the video, I will explain you how to create a QA tool with LangChain and Gemini 1.5 Pro. The idea of today is create from some PDFs documents a knowledge base. I will use a vector stored, a vector database to save all these documents in a embeddings format, and then I'll use this knowledge, it's a very specific knowledge about forensic medicine, and use this information hosted on this embedding database, use it as a context to help an LLM, which in this case is going to be Gemini 1.5 Pro, to answer questions related to that topic. The documents are in Spanish, so well, we will do have a second challenge here, because you probably the Gemini was trained with trillions of tokens, but the percentage of the Spanish language is very small in comparison with other languages. But in any case, you will see how good is performing and answering the tool. In this case, to join or to create all the components in a chain. I'm using as well LangChain, and you will be the process end to end. You will see the process end to end, and you will see as well at the end of the video how good is performing and answering in this case Gemini. Gemini in few words is really good performing, is extraordinary. I make different videos, you can look at them on the channel, not only using LangChain, most of them working on Vertex AI in Google, where I explain many things of how to use Gemini models, especially the multimodal models in creating prompts to extract information or providing context to queries using videos, audios, and also PDFs documents where you ask the model to extract information. We take advantage obviously of the long context windows, as you probably know. The version I'm gonna use here had the 2 million tokens context window, and really is doing very good job. So I create as usual a notebook that later I will post into the repository, and I will give you the link in the description of this video, and then you can later replicate this on your local environment. Sorry. So I assuming you had your account in Google, you had also Vertex AI activated, and you already have a service account to initialize and access via SDK and the API to the Vertex AI service. I also I pass you all the details to how to create the service account, and also you had videos in the channel how to create the service account and how to also access to Gemini AI and create the key case that you don't have these two necessary components to complete this video. I also pass you the details and the documentation of the main components of this small application. LangChain, the main components, create staff document chain, the retrieval component, and Chroma. We are using Chroma we can use any. Well, I decide to use Chroma because it's really simple. A PDF loader as well from LangChain, which extract the text from the documents and create the LangChain documents. The integration of the LangChain with the Gemini models. The two components I will use, one is a chat Google Generative AI, and the other one GenAI embeddings. So you can take a look to this documentation. It's at least to have an idea what we can do and what we cannot do. So Here I give you a list of the libraries that you need to install as well. Probably I miss some of them. I will review before I post the notebook. And okay, we just import what we need for this application. We load with the dot end values the all the configuration that you need, the project region and in the JSON file I had my service account in JSON format. I open it here, I create the credentials from my JSON, and then when I initialize the Vertex AI API using my project ID, region and the credentials. Additionally, I load into memory the Gemini API key. You had here a link in case that you don't have it, how to do it, and as well here you had how to create a custom service account. Then on I create a client, a ChromaDB, with some I decide to persist just to because there is a lot of documents, and then on to save the money in future requests. I don't need to, because here every time that you send obviously a page to Google for it to generate embeddings, it has a cost. You can use as well other technology. You can use transformers. This is not the embedding technology. I decided to use this because, well, I had everything on the same account and it was simple. But in any case, you can use even transformers and a non-commercial model to generate the embeddings. This is not it's not gonna be a problem. If we use a different embeddings from another technology different from the one we are going to use in the main LLM, which will answer the questions, is not really a problem. But in this case, again, I'm using generative the Google Generative AI Embedding class from the integration and chain Google Generative AI, just to, again, to make it a little bit more simple. But again, you can change whatever. And in this case as well, I take the embedding functions. This is a class from Chroma DB, and to generate a embedding function using our embeddings model. Take a look. This is the embeddings that we will use later in the retrieval tool. And here this embedding function is to encode the documents that we will save in our embeddings database. So that's why I'm creating two. One is for, again, creating the embeddings of every single page of our documents and save this into the database. And the second one is for the retriever. This is what dynamically during the query we will encode our query with this model, and then on the land chain it will take these embeddings, compare or send these embeddings to the database, make a query and compare these embeddings versus what we had on the database, and return the top key. Most depending on the your configuration in this project I'm using five, the top five documents closer that answer the query. And then be careful if you are using the same configuration. This generative AI embeddings function used by default models embedding 001. If you pretend to use the 004, change it accordingly or use it accordingly in both places. Here, as you can see here, the default is embedding 001. That's why here you also had the 001. Then on I iterate into my directory where I had all my files. There are documents basically related to legislation, law about forensic medicine, to This is coming from Spanish law, and yeah, well, for you, you can use whatever the code is gonna work with whatever you want to specialize or provide context to the model. No? So here, just I enumerate what I have on this folder, these files. And then on I create some helper functions. One is to load the file and transform it into launching documents with the PPY PDF loader. You just load the file and then on you split it by default is by page, page by page, and then on, what we return here is a list of launching documents containing the text of every single page and some metadata. I will show you now. Here, probably you can see here, I make an example here. I take a file, I load it, I just load and split, and you see you get this document has 283 pages. And here you see what is the content. This is just the first page, which is only the title, and then it contains the source, metadata source, which is the file name, and also the page that the front that create this document launching. So then on the second helper, I just create per document, I create a list of embeddings. So I send this get docs to add vector store. I send the pages extracted from a document on text, the file name, and the Google embedding function to embed the content in and generate an embedding for that page. So I generate the page, I append it to my list of embeddings, I append the metadata is just simply the page number and the file name. I generate an ID, unique ID, and I add the document content to the document list. I return the four lists. I create here a collection into my Chroma database with name forensics, and I add the embedding function. So here I just iterate through my list of files in the folder. I create the path, I get the pages, I just print the length and the file name. I get the four vectors with documents, IDs, metadata, and embeddings. And I add this document, all the pages, to my collection. And finally, just print the length of the collection. You can see here the iteration. I load in one by one, 673 pages, blah, 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 blah. This is really long. This is a very long file. The log is 360. Different legislation documents that all of them related to forensic medicine. So finally here after that we had 3,807 documents and vectors and metadata in our ChromaDB. So ChromaDB is persisted. For those that are not familiar, ChromaDB under the hood uses SQLite 3. This is the database that comes with Python 3. And here you see we had a very big size already. This database is very simple. But well, this is possible to handle this probably even up to 1 gigabyte is okay. You pretend to use with more or a bigger size, I recommend you to use probably Postgres pvector or pyvector. This is a derivative of Postgres, or use a technology like Pinecone, or as a vector store as a service. Okay, once you had all the documents in your vector store, I create a vector store with Chroma from LangChain. This is the object class that comes from LangChain integration with Chroma. I point to the folder, I send the embedding retriever. Look at this configuration because it's key. We cannot use the embedding function because the embedding function doesn't have one of the methods that is using embed query. The embedding function in Chroma doesn't have the embedding query method, and then you need to use this an object of the generative AI embedding class, which has this method on the class, and then you pass the collection name. As you probably know, we can have multiple collections in the Chroma database, similar to what you can do in the other technologies. Here we convert the vector store as a retriever, and then we pass as a number of documents to return file. The file more similar. By default, is going to use cosine similarity. Then we create our LLM. We are going to use Gemini 1.5 Pro 001, the latest one, and we pass our credentials. We create a template. The template had two inputs. We just need only to send this one because context will be populated directly by the LAN chain during the chain execution. So what will happen here is we will send a query. The first thing that LAN chain will do will be create a embedding for this query. It will send this query's embedding to the vector database, and it will find the file closest documents in terms of cosine similarity to the query that we send. These documents will be used as a context that later together, so context together with the input with this text will be sent to Gemini 1.5 Pro to as instruction, and then on the LLM will answer. So we provide five documents as context to answer this question, and the documents obviously we extracted from our vector database. So we create a template, and again the context is going to be populated directly by LangChain. The input is the query that you will send. We create a template with the prompt template class. We create an object, so they create documents combined class. Change combined documents, create a start document chain. And to this class, we pass the LLM and the prompt, and then we create the retriever chain with our retriever and the combined document chain. Now this we had the query ready. We create a query and we invoke. We can remove this because I tried to see all the steps, but it didn't work. We just asked the model, and essentially we retrieve this. The answer is that. It is correct. It's in Spanish, obviously. You check it out. I request something in Spanish, and the model is correctly replying me in Spanish as well, perfectly at the same time. The length of the response is 5, and this is the context that we send to the model. Paremo exactly from this document. We can iterate page by page and say from which document you got the most closest information. But in any case, this is exactly what I was trying to look for. And what you have here is a really powerful tool. You can create with this a bot. You can create specialize in any topic that you may have, technical, not technical, legal, whatever. You just feed the documents into the database, you create a collection, and then on you just on the collection, when you create the vector store that you are gonna use to as retriever, you just pass the collection name with your documents and you have it. You can just reuse the components, changing the name of the collection, and try and feed your vector stores with different topics, and you can have a very powerful agent that is able to answer very specialized topics in different languages. This is well, I didn't try with Chinese or some other specific language. I don't know how many percentage of these languages were included in the Gemini training, but from what you can see here, Spanish is the answer is quite impressive. And then and according to what I said, is really what is expected to receive. Additionally, you can simply, here I'm serializing the embeddings into the database, because obviously generating 3,807 embeddings has a cost, but you can decide not to use, in this case, this model. You can try, you can use a Transformers embedding, whatever model you had available there in the Sentence Transformer class, and instead to send it to Vertex AI for embeddings, you can just simply do it with your local model. And also, you instead to do it like this with persistence, you can do simply send a document to the use the vector database on memory, and fit some documents and use the ChromaDB on memory. Obviously, when the application use a done the application, the documents will go. You will lose the embeddings and everything, but you can also create something that don't need any kind of persistence. And that's all. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you like it and you find it useful, informative, and helpful for your job or your training. And it is like it, give me a like, subscribe to the channel, and help me to promote the channel in YouTube with sharing with other colleagues and friends, and making comments and these kind of things. Thank you very much. See you soon.